Welcome to the Fit Small Business Xero Training Course. In the previous lesson, we showed you how to get paid faster by accepting online payments from your customers. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to reconcile online payments and fees from a credit card processor in Xero. So follow along with me, log into your Xero account now, or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. You can also click this link to access our full Xero course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. As we discussed in the How to Reconcile Bank Accounts lesson, reconciling is the process of making sure that your bank account matches your accounting software. This also applies to online payments from customers that have been credited to your bank account, along with any fees the merchant has charged you. You can click here to access the bank reconciliation lesson. We'll be using PayPal as an example, but the reconciliation process should be similar for other payment processing services. To reconcile online payments and fees, from the Xero dashboard, you want to go ahead and scroll down. In this example, we're going to scroll down to our PayPal account, and you want to click the button that says Reconcile to Items. So the number of items may vary, but you want to click this button here to get to the reconciliation screen. On the left side of the screen is a list of the transactions that have automatically downloaded from your bank. So in this example, these transactions here on this side of the screen have downloaded directly from PayPal. In the How to Set Up a Bank Account lesson, we showed you how to set up bank feeds. Be sure to watch this video tutorial to learn how to set up a bank feed account. You can click here to access this lesson. Please note, a PayPal bank account must be set up to track payments received. However, most merchants will deposit directly to your existing business checking account. On the right side of the screen, you're going to see transactions that have already been recorded in Xero. As you learned in the last lesson, when a customer makes a payment, Xero will reduce the account's receivable balance and mark the invoice as paid behind the scenes. Xero will also record the fee charged by PayPal or your payment service. If you choose to have Xero automatically record the fee, basically you would determine this when you set up the PayPal account in Xero. Otherwise, if Xero does not automatically record the fee, then you will need to create a spend money transaction to record any merchant fees that have been deducted from your bank account. You can click here to access the lesson on spend money transactions. Xero will attempt to match transactions that have downloaded from your bank or merchant to transactions that have been recorded in Xero. So essentially, Xero would attempt to match these transactions on the left with transactions that are already in your Xero account on the right. For transactions that it has attempted to match, you will see a button with the word OK, similar to these two transactions listed here. So let's take a look at these transactions. On the left-hand side of the screen, we'll see a customer payment that was made on July 23rd for $1. So on the left-hand side of the screen, this is the credit from your bank for the payment itself. On the right side of the screen, this entry was recorded once your customer went into their invoice and clicked Pay Now, and they entered their credit card information. So you want to notate that the reference number information here at the bottom, starting with 07K477, matches the reference number that's located here on the right side of the transaction here. So based on the date of the transaction, the amount, and of course the reference number, these are more than likely accurate matches. And so to accept the match, all you have to do is click the OK button to accept it. The second transaction here is a fee that was charged by PayPal for the transaction that we just reconciled. So on the left-hand side here, this is the fee that was deducted directly from your bank account for 33 cents. On the right side, we have a spend money transaction that was recorded automatically by Xero. As I mentioned previously, you can set PayPal up or your payment service up to where Xero will automatically record the fee for you. If you don't set up the account to automatically record the fee, you will need to set up a spend money transaction as mentioned previously. So once again, based on the date, the amount, information, we can go ahead and accept this item to reconcile it. So we'll click OK here. Once you have successfully reconciled your transactions, you should see a notification similar to this one confirming that you have reconciled your transactions, which means that the balance with your bank account matches what you have in your Xero account. If you are having a difficult time reconciling, refer to the reconciling tips that we shared with you in the How to Reconcile a Bank Account video tutorial for help. You can click the link below to access this lesson. We return back to our Xero dashboard and scroll down. So now instead of seeing items to reconcile, you'll see this green check mark with the reconciled indication here, letting you know that everything has been reconciled. So that wraps up the lesson on how to reconcile credit card payments and fees from a merchant in Xero. To access our full Xero course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of Xero. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.